Hey, this is Travis. In this video, we are going to look at the evolution and history of blockchains, specifically for product designers. This is an extension to the Web3 design course that I have previously put out on my YouTube channel. And we're going to get an understanding of where blockchains came from, where we're at today, and where this blockchain layer one landscape is heading in the future. The first blockchain ever was Bitcoin, and it was released by an anonymous person named Satoshi Nakamoto in 2009. So he released this open source software, and ever since then, this Bitcoin blockchain has been running. And Bitcoin really excels at a simple use case, which is it tracks the movement of Bitcoin cryptocurrency. So there's a Bitcoin blockchain, and then it tracks the movement of Bitcoin between addresses. You can think of it as a ledger where you see a wallet address and you see the Bitcoin balance associated with that wallet address. So it's a very simple use case, and it solves a decentralized digital currency use case. This was in 2009. Moving to 2015, we had the next evolution of blockchains, which was Ethereum. And Ethereum was the advent of smart contract blockchains. So whereas Bitcoin is used to just as a simple decentralized digital currency, Ethereum adds a layer of complexity on top where developers can now deploy decentralized applications to the Ethereum blockchain. And Ethereum can run more complex programs on top of it as opposed to Bitcoin. So it's a good analogy to think that if Bitcoin is the calculator app on your smartphone, then Ethereum is the smartphone itself. So Ethereum is more of a platform, and Bitcoin is a specific app on that platform, if that makes sense. So if Ethereum is a smartphone, then third-party developers can come in, deploy dApps, and it's like this Apple App Store that you have where third-party developers are building out the ecosystem with third-party applications. So this was a major evolution in blockchains, and we're calling this Blockchain 2.0, which now brings us to the present moment and sort of looking into the future here for Blockchain 3.0. There are many emerging smart contract blockchains that we are also calling layer one blockchains. And so this is a very competitive space right now. They are all vying for position in this new landscape. Whoever can solve the blockchain problem the best could stand to make billions and trillions of dollars over the next several decades. This could be a fundamental platform that we're using on into the future. So it's a very exciting time. A lot of different founding teams are throwing different design philosophies at it. These blockchains have their own developer communities and user communities. They have their own culture. They have their own currencies, and they're a lot like nation states in this regard. It's a very interesting time to be alive and to be witnessing this this competition between layer ones. And it doesn't necessarily have to be one layer one that wins out at the end of the day, as we'll see later on. And I'm going to go into detail in the next videos on each of these phases that will probably live in a multi-chain future, so that these layer one blockchains, there's going to be multiple of them eventually, and they will be specialized for specific use cases.